Good evening, I'm Christian Esguerra, and welcome to this episode of After the Fact, where we get to see things more clearly, where we get a better sense of the truth. So let's start by dissecting the news. Less than 2 months before candidates officially declared their intention to run in the 2022 elections, the opposition forces are looking for a common candidate to go up against President Rodrigo Duterte's candidate, or even Duterte himself, who is expected to run for vice president. Senator Pamphilo Lacson recently came out with a formula. Why don't he and Vice President Lenny Robredo both file their certificates of candidacy in October? Then whoever gets the better serving numbers afterward, meaning a better chance of defeating the administration candidate, proceeds, while the other one withdraws. Robredo rejected the Lacson formula, saying she didn't want to lead her supporters on. If ever she decided to run, there's no turning back. How then do you unify a fragmented opposition, whose disunity can only make it easier for Duterte forces to remain in power beyond 2022? Now be part of our discussion, send us your questions and comments on our YouTube live chat or tweet us using the hashtag ANCAfterTheFact. Joining us tonight is Bayan Muna Partidist Representative Carlos Zarate and isang bayan convener, former Negros Occidental Governor Rafael Lito Cospuluela. Good evening, gentlemen, and thank you for joining us on the program tonight.
Good evening, Christian.
Okay, I'll start with Congressman Caloy Zarate. You came out with a statement saying that the opposition should be open to all options as far as unifying all groups under the opposition umbrella is concerned for the 2022 elections. But specifically, what do you think of this formula proposed by Senator Pamphilo Lacson to Vice President Lenny Robredo?
Thank you, Christian. The survey is just one tool, I think, to gauge the capacity of one group or a candidate to win an election. But that should not be the only requirement or qualification on how to wage a campaign. Remember, yung survey naman is just a representation of a segment of our electorates. It will not totally or absolutely represent the entire electorates. No? So what matters in an election is also the machinery, the resources, the grassroots campaigner. And in this case, we're even proposing that we should make this as a people's movement. If we don't want another 6 years of this kind of governance that the Duterte administration gave us in the past 5 years, then let's involve more people. Make this as a grassroots movement. So I think that's my take on the formula presented or by Senator Lacson. I'm not saying we don't use that as a gauge at this point. In fact, I'm saying let us open to other formula for that matter and come up with a common ground and set some clear basis of unity also for all these democratic forces that wants to put up a unified slate against any of the candidate or variants of the Duterte governance, Christian.
Okay, but even if you go that route, meaning converting this into a movement, you would still have to contend with different personalities who might be seeking the presidency as well as part of the opposition. But how do you select them or that lone candidate that would represent the opposition?
Well, as it is now, Christian, we are supporting the process initiated by isang bayan. In fact, some of our colleagues are conveners of isang bayan, and we continue to support and encourage that this process be continued. While we also, of course, respect the individual initiatives of some personalities, talking to each other, like Vice President Lenny talking to Senator Lacson, Senator Pacquiao talking to Vice President Lenny, and the others like Mayor Isko. No? But at the end of the day, of course, the clock is ticking. October 1 is fast approaching. We have to, gather as much, we want to gather the broader coalition, it will really come to a point that we need to make a decision sooner or later. And so far, I think the process being conducted by Sambayan is continuing. It's moving, and it's and this is the process that we want also to succeed. No? If we want to have a unified slate in the coming May 2022 election.
Okay, let's ask the Sambayan convener, former Governor Lito Coscoluela, what do you think of this Lacson formula? He and Vice President Leni Robredo would both file their certificates of candidacy for president in October, and then whatever the numbers based on the surveys would show afterward, one would back out, the other would proceed. What do you think of this formula?
Well, actually, I think it's, no, on the surface, it's a magnanimous move by Senator Ping. Because from my point of view, this is my personal view, pag dinaan mo sa survey, matatalo si Ping. No? I mean, you know, from all indications. So he's practically giving the plate to Vice President Leni Robredo if the Vice President decides to run. Okay? But Representative Caloy is correct, no? Isambayan is not going to base its decision purely on the results of surveys. Among others, there will be internal polls conducted among members from all over the Philippines, yung mga iba-ibang chapters, all the members who have signed up. They will be asked, sino ba ang gusto nyo? Okay? And I mean, from my point of view, mukhang klaro naman kung sino ang gusto. Okay? And I think Ping knows that. On the other hand, there are several problems that get in the way of selecting a common candidate, opposition candidate. The first big problem is hindi pa masyadong klaro sino ba talaga ang opposition.
Yes.
Okay. And there are many answers. Okay. Some people are saying only those who from the very start were already anti-Duterte. There are others who say, well, some people have changed their minds and they are now critics of the administration. And this brings us to the next problem. You have purists who say absolutely no to anyone who smells a little of Duterte. Okay? And then on the other end, you have your pragmatists who say politics is addition and therefore we need to get as many allies as we can, regardless of their previous alliance with Duterte or their positions on certain issues. No? The ones in the middle, and I think this is where Ping is trying to fit himself in, are the so-called unification advocates. They're saying the bottom line is let's change the administration first. And the only way to do that is to unite all of those who are against the administration, regardless of prior record. Okay, so that complicates the selection process because, as you probably know, Christian, Isambayan, the convener's group, is composed of a wide array of different interest groups. And you know, you should hear all the discussions that take place. No? So these are the problems we're facing now.
So in your case, are you a pragmatist, a purist, or someone who is in the middle?
I tend to be in the middle. What I believe is that the next president really ought to try to unify the nation. We cannot have a situation where, you know, the lines are drawn between Dilawan and Pula, no? Or this party and that party. We don't have the luxury of political division in the next 6 years. So if it is at all possible to unite all of those who are saying the bottom line is to replace the administration and its candidates and to introduce a climate where you now will be able to realize good governance. Of course, our thinking is that all of those who propose to join the opposition must sign a commitment and follow the principles upheld by the Isang Bayan.
But let me challenge you on that, sir. Okay. How confident are you that whoever would be picked by Isang Bayan as its common candidate, whether it's a purist decision or a pragmatic decision or somewhere in the middle, that person would actually respect that covenant, that commitment? We know that such things, sorry for sounding very cynical, but I know this is true. Covenants are meaningless.
Well, spoken like a pragmatist, yes. That's very true, Christian. But, you know, you have to begin somewhere. And that somewhere is making all those who come in sign a commitment. Now, of course, if they break the commitment, then that, you know, that just shows what kind of people they are, no? But we're hopeful at the same time that
hello. I think we're having problems with the signal coming from Mr. Coscaluela. I'd like to go to Congressman Caloy Zarate first. We've heard the three.
The better cell surveys.
Okay. That's... okay. We'll try to fix the line from your end. Congressman Zarate, what do you think of these categories? Basically, you have the purists, the pragmatists, and the so-called unifying force in the middle. First of all, does Ping Lacson fit the bill?
Well, at this point, Christian, we need all the forces that can we got, that we can gather, no? Marshal all the forces that we can gather that will go against the candidates of the Duterte administration. And at this point, well, that is true. I'm not really privy to the discussions of in the discussions, no, within Sambayan, but as I've read, there are really different forces. There are these pragmatists, purists, and as mentioned by Governor Lito, even in the middle. But that is really the nature of building a coalition. It's painstaking, but we really have to push the envelope to the limit. No, push the envelope so that. Because what is at stake here, and kept on saying, it's not just the survival of one group, one coalition, one party. It is the survival of our people, our country. We can no longer, I think, accept the fact that another 6 years of Duterte governments will happen after 2022. So at this point, even if it is painstaking, even if it is, beset with a lot of challenges, as Governor Lito said earlier, we have to start somewhere. We have to start somewhere because this is a very important chance for us to make a difference, to change what is currently happening in our country right now.
Okay. As Bayan Muna Party List representative, do you trust Senator Ping Lacson?
Of course, at this point, since there is this, coming together of all these forces, and I understand in this process, we have to also abide by certain basis of unity. And if Senator Lacson or whoever will abide by this basis of unity or the standards, for example, the criteria set up, put up by Sambayan, if they will abide by the covenant that will later on be put up by Sambayan, then we welcome that, no? For as long as that this is for the good, no, of our country. So I think at this point we cannot just close any door, no? especially that we are building this coalition.
So because I know that you and your group have a deep ideological difference with the likes of Senator Panfilo Lacson, you're willing to set aside those differences just to make sure that this coalition that you're building would be able to defeat Duterte's candidate in 2022?
Well, as I've said, Christian, for as long as at least a minimum basis of unity will be observed by the parties, that is true, no? We have differences, principal differences with Senator Lacson, but in some issues, we are also allies. For example, in the anti-pork barrel campaign, we have been together in several campaigns on the issue of pork barrel. But of course, on the issue, for example, of the anti-terror law, we really were at odds, no, on that particular issue. But again, this is the point that in the building of this coalition, it's really a give and take situation. One party or one group cannot just dominate, and just have to accept the fact that what is the real issue here is we have to replace the one sitting in Balacanang in June 30, 2022.
Okay. Governor Coscolwella, same question. Yes. For you.
Yeah.
Can Senator Ping Lacson be trusted to to lead the opposition against Duterte's candidate in 2022?
At this point in time, Christian, I would have to give him the benefit of the doubt. Okay. You have to presume that he is just as interested in seeing the right kind of change. So I would even say we have no choice but to trust him as an ally. As to whether I believe that he will be the leader capable of bringing everybody together, I might have some problems there. But as an ally, I would say that he deserves the benefit of the doubt.
Okay, but again, that is the question that you posed earlier. It's a very common question that we're hearing in terms of in the context of trying to unify the opposition forces. I'd like to throw that question to Congressman Zarate, who basically is the opposition here. You have a very problematic political party system in the Philippines. One politician jumps from one party to another. Political parties are basically meaningless. So in this context, especially with the upcoming elections in 2022, who is the opposition?
Well, of course, Christian, if you limit the definition of opposition to those who are opposed to the policies or critics of the Duterte administration, you will be really limiting the option of building a coalition. This is my personal take on this matter. If you broaden the meaning of the opposition, meaning those who are opposed to the Duterte clique, and for as long as they will abide with the minimum basis of unity that will be agreed upon by those who want to be part of that coalition, then they can be considered also as opposition, in the sense that they are in opposition to extending the influence and control of the Duterte clique beyond June 30, 2022. But then again, as I've said, this is a painstaking process of getting together people, no? Because magkaiba talaga ang posisyon ng marami. But that is a challenge now for the conveners, for example, of Sambayan, where a lot of us are also supporting, you know, this process of Sambayan to drive home the point, no, that this is beyond a single group, a single party, a single personality. What is at stake here, as I've said earlier, it's the future of our country, the survival of our country.
Okay. Governor Coscolwella, how close are you or far away still from identifying that lone candidate for the opposition for president in 2022?
there's a calendar that we have, and it calls for a decision to be made within the next month. Okay. Personally, I'd like to see a decision made before the end of this month. But there's one major problem that's holding us back. Vice President Lenny Robredo has not yet indicated formally whether she's running for president or not. No? And in fact, there is a pending request for her to be interviewed by the conveners with regards to her program of governance and what she proposes to do if and when she gets elected as president. So please remember, Christian, that we cannot move forward and select the vice presidential candidate and the senatorial candidates until we've selected the presidential candidate, because his or her preference for vice president and senatorial candidates will have a certain percentage. Okay, that will not be the lone criteria, but it will be an important part of the selection process. So we really need to start with selecting the presidential standard bearer. Okay. And again, what I'm saying is we're probably seeing somewhere within the next month.
Okay, I spoke with some members of certain opposition forces, and honestly, or to be quite frank about it, they also raised certain issues regarding the selection process. One of those that I spoke with a few months back said that the fact that you're using the term interview, for instance, and then you have the so-called self-appointed conveners, might seem like you just came out with a group, perhaps dominated by the elite, to which a candidate should be interviewed and then would have to apply for the position of a standard bearer. How do you respond to that? Because the other point is that the right way to do this, the selection process? Or perhaps you should really go down to the grassroots and make those voices from the ground heard?
That's exactly the intent of Isambayan, Christian. First of all, I don't agree that Isambayan is dominated by the elite. Okay, in fact, that's the impression that's been created because the high-profile personalities would, as you say, belong to the elite. No, Justice Carpio, etc. But below that level, we have a huge range of interests, including urban poor, farmers and fisher folk, the youth, and all these other sectors that have wanted to have a voice in selecting candidates. Okay, and that is in fact an
We're having problems with the connection again. I think I'd like to ask that same question to you, Congressman Zarate. What do you think of that observation?
Well, again, I disagree. Just like Governor Lito, that impression is not entirely correct, because I know for the fact that there are grassroots movement within Sambayan. No? There are several these town hall meetings that were already conducted by Sambayan, initiated by grassroots organizations. For example, the indigenous peoples, the urban poor, and overseas Filipino workers. No? So this is the way of Sambayan to reach to a much broader, no? Broader base. Consulting many groups and organizations as possible,
but
to come up with the consensus.
But even then, Congressman Zarate, you will have to make a decision or a choice from among prominent names because they have supposedly a better chance of winning. even if, let's say, certain grassroots level groups, certain indigenous people's groups prefer a candidate who is not well known on the national stage, but they think that this person can actually win, they cannot actually push for that nomination because they know that they have a very, it's close to impossible that they would win the presidential election. So again, isn't this just, again, a reflection of the elite democracy that we actually have in the Philippines, but somehow it's just being tweaked and tried, and we're all attempting to make this more participative because of this combined coalition process.
Well, you're correct, Christian. Our election is still dominated by the elite. Ours is still an elite dominated democracy. And this problem is truly systemic. There are reforms that were already made in the past, but of course that is not enough. So, but then again, the central issue now, leading towards 2022, is are we ready for another 6 years, or are we do we have to change the present kind, the kind of governance that we have now? And we are confronted, all of us are confronted, not just the Dilawan, the Kuda, or the other groups, no? All of us are confronted with the same issues. Do we want this kind of kill, kill, kill mentality that will continue beyond June 30 of 2022? No? So, but of course, as a matter of principle, hindi natin kinakalimutan na napakarami pang masalimuot na problema ang ating electoral system na dapat yes. Hindi baguhin. If we really want to put in place meaningful changes in our society. Mm-hmm. So, but of course, it's a building block that have to be surmounted by our people, no? And this is one challenge na kinakaharap natin in June 30 of 2020, of May okay. of 2022.
Okay, Governor Coscoluela is back. Let's continue what you were talking about there. I asked Congress Mazarate to respond to that same question. Kasi nga, kahit nagpipilian tayo dito sa grassroots, no, eventually the choices are limited. You're still you still have to contend with the popular names because they have a better chance of winning. Kahit for example, may isang magsasaka dyan, isang lawyer na talagang supportive of the urban poor na ang galing-galing, na mas magaling pa dihamak siguro sa maraming senador ngayon, but that person might not be that popular, he would not be selected at all because you have to contend with the reality that this is still an elite democracy that we have here in the Philippines.
Yes, that's true. That's correct. But as I said, we have